All right, back with us and back inside the octagon this Saturday is Devonte Smith, although the man standing across from him at the apex will not be the same man he was originally signed to face. He now faces Justin Jaynes, first fight back since August of 2019, 539 long days it will be for King Cage. Welcome back to Fight Week, my man. How are you?
I'm good, man. I'm excited. It's Fight Week. I don't want to cuss. I want to say it's mother effing Fight Week. But I'm excited, bro.
539 days, man. When you hear that number, like, what goes through your mind?
Shoot. I mean, it's a lot to think of right now because I didn't even think of it. I didn't even know it was that long. But hearing it now is like, I don't know. It's something I can brag about, you know? So it's like, yeah, I ain't fighting for over 500 days. So, you know, I'm excited to get back in there and, you know, start that clock over.
How does this fight week feel compared to others because of the long layoff? I mean, does it feel like the same as the others, or does this one feel a little different, like a little more intensity because it's been so long?
No, man, it feels the same. It feels the same. I mean, I've been training. You feel what I'm saying? So it's like I wasn't able to during the training sessions. I wasn't able to like hurt my sparring partners. But I got to fight. I got to train. I got to do everything I need to do, whether it's wrestling, jits, boxing, kickboxing, Muay Thai, all those cool things. The only difference is now I don't have to worry about somebody saying, you're trying to kill me. You're going too hard. Like, I can, like, freely, you know, do me, you know? So there's really no difference. I keep saying it, but that's what it is. I'm just excited to get back in there.
So as most people know by now, you suffered an Achilles injury, you had surgery at the end of 2019, and coming back, you wanted to take a very slow, patient, methodical approach towards getting back into the octagon. Now, you know, you had the surgery, you weren't going to allow yourself essentially to get back in there until you were 100%, no matter how big that itch was to get back in there. So when did you get sort of the go-ahead, the clearance, so to speak, to get back in there and eventually put a fight on the books?
After a year, you know, you get so many different opinions. Sometimes I heard you'd be cool after 6 months. Sometimes I heard you'd be good at 8 months. But I wanted to wait a year because, you know, the doctor that I was working with told me it's not going to get any better after a year. But that's like for the most part, that's the best it's going to get. So I wanted to make sure. You know, for that whole, I want to make sure that I was 100%, you know, or as close as I can be to 100% so I can be me without thinking about, shoot, what about my Achilles? Shoot, should I be acting like this? Shoot, what if it ruptures again? You know, and I knew waiting that long period of time, like you said, no matter how bad that itch was, I just knew for the longevity of my career, it was a smart thing to do, you know.
Yeah, and it was smart because you were still getting work in. You were becoming like a bodybuilder the last time I talked to you. You were hitting the weights hard. You were doing what you could with what you had,
right?
Because sitting on your ass and healing was not something you enjoyed or wanted to do whatsoever. So, I mean, once you got the all clear, pen went to paper for a fight, head back to Colorado. I mean, what was it like getting back into training like that? Was it like riding a bike, or was it kind of humbling at first?
By riding a bike, you meaning like, you know, you never forget how to ride a bike?
Yeah, kind of.
Yeah, pretty much. Once, like, because, you know, I took my time, you know, so before I even came out to Colorado, you know, I had a little training sessions here and there with a boxing coach, jiu-jitsu coach, Muay Thai coach. But they understood, you know, my mission. You know, they understood my goal, which was, you know, take my time and ease my way into it. So when I finally, you know, was able to go for real and come out to Colorado, I was doing me. It was, you know, people was even telling me that my boxing got so much better. You know, like you said, I was working out, and my strength and conditioning coach out in Cleveland, Ohio, Ray Terry, he works you. So his thing is muscle fatigue. So when I came out back out to Colorado, I wasn't even getting tired, you know? So it was really like I just jumped back in, you know?
How does it feel now? Like with with like the exercise, the bodybuilding, the lifting and all that stuff you did, do you feel different? Like, is there a little more explosiveness to you that maybe wasn't there before? Like, what does it feel any different, I guess, is what I'm asking.
At first it did, especially when like the, cause I came out here, let's say a month or two before I signed the contract, I came back out here for a cannabis sponsor. So, okay, you know, I had to come up to the gym and I drilled with a couple of the guys on a jiu-jitsu day. And I felt so much more explosive, you know, with the things that I was working back at home. And they were telling me I felt stronger. But since I came out back out here and did my 10 months, I'm sound crazy, did my 2.5 months working out on different things because they train different out here. It's kind of like I don't have as much as I did with the bodybuilding stuff I was doing, but it's still, you know, just as good, you know?
Did it take a while for you to trust the Achilles in like sparring and in the gym and stuff? Like, cause it's natural to have some inclination, especially early on, like you'd been rehabbing it, you had done some work, but in sort of a combat situation with live bodies and such, did you need some time to trust it and get acclimated with everything?
Yeah, when I was back at home and I was able to do a little bit more than just work out, I only trained with people that understood my situation. I only trained people who did not have too big of an ego and, you know, wanted to learn but not trying to kill me and, you know, not trying to overdo things. So I got to, like I said, ease my way in, you know, in trusting it. And in certain situations, let's say they would ask, let's say if they try to trip me, they would accidentally kick my Achilles and I would be able to keep going because I wouldn't feel no pain. It'd feel like my other leg. And I just built off that confidence, you know? So when I was able to come out here to Colorado, it was just another day.
When did you find out that things were getting switched around for Saturday, that Alex Da Silva was out of the fight, Justin Jaynes was stepping in? When were you made aware that things were not going to be the way that you originally thought they were going to be?
I believe last week, you know, we heard some things about, I don't know if it's true or not, but about his knee and stuff like that. And you were like, you know, he's about to go get it checked out. And so that pretty much means he's out. And I was like, I mean, I've been through this before. Truthfully, I've been through this with all my fights, especially in the UFC. And I didn't even notice it until my coach brought it up. Like, why are you always getting an opponent switch? I'm like, I don't know. I mean, you know, I think people are scared or maybe they going too hard. And I mean, it is what it is. You know, hopefully he heals up and everything's cool with him. But once I found out it was Justin Jaynes, man, it's different opponent, you know, same mission, same goal. And that's the win. That's the only thing that's on my mind for real is to win and just to get back out there, you know, and get a dub.
Because it's kind of similar to the Kamaworthy one, right? It was like right around a week before, you know, I'm sure it's easier not having to fight a good friend and a training partner this time around. But, yeah, you know, is it kind of like deja vu in a way?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. But it's like I said, I've been through this already. So it's like chaos. So it's just like, I was talking to the coach today because he was explaining to me, Mark Montoya, he was explaining to me how this whole COVID thing works now. And I was like, I'm cool. Like, you know, I'm cool that it's a different opponent. But I was like, man, it's not a friend. So, I mean, I kind of went through this already. It's just another day, bro.
I know with like Da Silva, you weren't like, you knew what his pedigree was as a jiu-jitsu guy. And I know you're not like afraid to go to the ground with a jiu-jitsu player like Alex Da Silva. But with Jaynes, I mean, you know what you're getting. You're getting a guy who likes to throw them bolos. He's a tough dude. He's got a killer, be killed mentality. In a way, first fight back, do you kind of prefer this matchup more because of the style that Justin brings?
You know what? It really didn't matter to me, but when I think about it, it just seems more, I hate to say it, you know, hate is a strong word, but it seems more fun. You know, Alex, he seemed like he was going to be a type of guy, as soon as he get touched the wrong way, he wants to wrestle, he wants to tussle, you know? Everybody got time for that, you know? But Justin seems like, you know, seems, you never know, but seems like the type that would love to stand up, go out on his shield, like you said, kill or be killed mentality. and it's the Apex cage. So it was a smaller cage. So it's that's the mentality in general. Kill or be killed, you know, because it's only so much space.
Now he's gonna shoot. He's gonna shoot in like 5 seconds into this fire now, right?
I'm like, he probably will, you know. But
are you excited to fight in front of no crowd? I mean, because this is the first time you fought throughout all of this. They went through an entire year of this, no fans. Like you said, Apex, smaller cage. You excited for kind of a different look and feel to what you've seen in the past?
I don't even think about that for real, to tell the truth. It's, if there is a crowd, cool. If it's not a crowd, cool. I know now how a crowd can kind of tweak with your mind a little bit. But like the Contender Series, there really wasn't a lot of people there anyway. Like I said, the only thing I'm focused on is the win. So whether Dana White's there, not there, McGregor's there, not there, Khabib's there, Snoop Dogg's there, I don't care. I'm here to fight and win. And then if I see them, like, oh, you was here? Cool. Then, you know what I'm saying, we'll talk, we'll chop it, and then we'll move, go on from there.
You've obviously, over these last year and a half, it's been a kind of a rough go. You've healed physically, emotionally, spiritually, you know, with everything you've just gone through. I know going in there and getting your hand raised, this is what it's all about, man. You want to go in there, put on a performance. Devonte Smith is back. Are you like, is there moral victories attached to your career? Like, is you just walking to that octagon on Saturday night after all of this, is this like the first of hopefully two wins for you?
That's a good question, bro. I guess so. Yeah. You know, just to get this out the way, because my goal is to fight at least 3-4 times out this year. You know, because I want to stay active, but I also want to spend time with my family, you know, because that's also what's important to me. So going out there and doing what I need to do, you know, that's it. You know, just go out there, do what I need to do, get the win, go back home to my family, and you know, just relax, you know, and just be surrounded by people that, you know, truly love me. Not saying the people of Factory X don't love me, but, you know what I'm saying, it's my blood. So, you know, I miss Cleveland. I love Colorado, but I miss Cleveland.
Aside from getting the win, what is the goal on Saturday night? Is it just to go in there and just have some fun and just get that feeling again, or is there something else like more competitive based on your mind?
It's either knockout, TKO, unanimous decision, split decision. As long as I win, submission, you know, surprise some people. As long as I win, that's all I care about, because as long as you win, everything else falls in place.
There you go, man. What did you think of Dustin Poirier's win over Connor? Same division, could man, be the champ. What'd you think of that?
That was a crazy fight, man. Like, I see a lot of different opinions and stuff like that. I don't think Connor took it too serious, you know, because he wasn't the same Connor in the sense of, like, you know, his aura. You know, I feel like it seemed like he thought it was going to be a walk in the park the way he was kind of moving. I'm a little iffy, you know what I'm saying, on that. I ain't never been kicked in the calf before type thing, because it's like, but whatever, you know. But to be the first guy to actually knock McGregor out, man, that's such a big accomplishment. I was a little salty in a sense of like, dang, I wanted to be the guy. But, you know, hats off to Dustin. And, you know, I hear talks about him and what's her boy name? Charles Oliveira. I think that'd be a good fight, man. But McGregor, depending on how he moves, going off his past, he seems like the type of guy that gets right back on the horse and, like, you know, go even harder. Like, because maybe his mind wasn't in it. Maybe his mind was more so on money. You know, and, you know, the whiskey, no disrespect to his stuff. I don't really be paying attention too much about certain things, but, and I feel like that burn or that L and actually being knocked out, it's going to push him to, like, okay, you know, screw the money. I want the belt, you know, screw the entertainment and all this extra stuff. I want the belt, you know? So it is what it is, man. Learn and grow.
I think they're going to do it again. That's my pick. I think they're going to run it back a third time, and come what may. I think they're just going to do it, get it done, see what happens. But and Dustin, I mean, Dustin wants to be the champion, but if he even said like in an interview earlier that I saw today that if the UFC booked like Chandler versus Oliveira for the belt, he'll sit back and just watch and fight the winner.
Yeah, that'd be, bro, that Michael Chandler fight, that was, man, soon as they started, bro, and I see, I know it's because he was Bellator, not a UFC, so you don't really know what he's going to do, but when I seen him sit down, and I seen Hooker standing up, I'm like, he's shell-shocked, but he, like, timid. You know, the way he was throwing his kicks and everything, and the way he was, like, backing up and not, like, cutting the angle to take the middle. And just – and I seen him trying to set up that shot. He was touching the body, but I seen he was trying to set up that shot. But when he hit him with that left, man, that was crazy. So, you know, welcome to the UFC. Much respect to Michael Chandler. Yeah, man, to be a wrestler and actually got some power, that's a different different breed. Different breed. So that's cool. That's cool.
You came back at the right time, man. This division, like, has always been exciting, but this is the most exciting it's ever been.
Yeah. So I'm glad to be. I'm a part, but I'm not a part yet, if you feel what I'm saying. Like, I'm a part in a sense of because I'm in the UFC and I'm a 155er, but I'm not a part yet because I'm not ranked yet. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't really care about rankings, but I'm not fighting the top 10, top 5 people. And once I'm there, then I'll feel like I'm a part, you know?
We don't want to look past Saturday, obviously, because you're fighting a really tough dude in Justin Jaynes, who's got that power and can put the lights out in a heartbeat. But I don't know if you're a guy that, like, looks so far ahead, but if we're having this conversation December 31st, 2021, what are we talking about? Where are we at? Are we sniffing the rankings? Are we in the top 15 yet? 3 to 4 fights? Like, what are we going to be talking about, you think?
I feel like if I'm on my third, fourth fight, I'm most definitely fighting top 15, if not top 10, because confidence is going to be through the roof for good reasons. And, you know, I'm going to be very active and I'm going to just be gaining experience, you know? Depending on who all I go against, I'm going to be gaining more and more experience. And with the help of Factory X and all my teammates down there, you know, my dude Yusuf Zalal fighting too. You know, everybody down there at Factory X, man, you know, big help when it comes to, you know, confidence and technique and IQ and growth. And, you know, as good as everybody say that I am, I be taking some L's too at the gym, man. I be taking some L's too, but it's those L's that help me grow, you know? So in this year, and that, yeah, that, thank you. I'm going to put that down too, write that down. But in this year, third, fourth fight, everything goes well, is either top 15 or top 10.
So basically your message to the top 15 is enjoy the work from a distance, but I'm coming.
Oh, exactly. Oh, man. In the most humblest way, though.
Right. You're gonna see Devonte Smith at the end of 2021, ladies and gentlemen. But listen, man, I gotta say, I'm super happy you're back. I'm really excited about this. I know you and I have had some conversations. We haven't really been able to talk about fight stuff because you've been healing and rehabbing. But finally, we get to talk about fights. It's a fight week for you, and you're back in there against Justin Jaynes this Saturday, man. So looking forward to it. Welcome back to Fight Week, and all the best to you on Saturday, man.
Much appreciated, bro. Much appreciated.